Cats and the Red Storm, Northeast Conference against the Big East, get set to go here at the bank. Happy holidays to everybody out there, and should be warm and toasty in here. Should be a pretty good game, Billy.
Well, I think it's a big game for Quinnipiac. You know, again, you're taking one of the story programs in the country in St. John's, a name that's synonymous with basketball success, and you got them at your home, and credit to Trish again for not being afraid, Billy, to schedule up, and they've had some success, and it's an important game for Quinnipiac as they measure themselves against the best in the country.
Blue numbers, blue and gold trim. The opening tip taken by St. John's. Driving down to the basket and laying it in is McKenna. Is it ahead to McKenna? McKenna quickly out of the backcourt to the left side. Dishes underneath Brown and lays it in.
Well, that McKenna girl can go.
Off McKenna. McKenna quickly out of the backcourt into the lane. Dishes down low to Smith and lays it in. Get it down low to Guastella. Double team gets it out to Abshire. Fakes. Has room. Gives it off Martin for three. It's
great
good.
Possession. They needed that.
Down low to McQueen. Gets double team. Throws cross court. Barron on the right side. Guastella for three. It's good. 24-15, 9-point St. John's lead. Guastella for three is good.
Yeah, she's a girl that brings incredible energy to Quinnipiac. You're going to get a timeout.
St. John's is feeling a little pressure now. Three threes in a row for Quinnipiac.
Now throws top of the key to Ostergaard, who's in the lineup. Down the right side, drives and lays it in.
Great.
Steps, gives it off to Ostergaard. Ostergaard drives. Player falls down. Ostergaard pumps and hits. Lane jumps past left side. Ostergaard fakes. Goes to the basket. Lays it up. And hits.
That girl's putting on a clinic.
Yes,
real good shot. Fake. Baseline. Good move.
Kicks it out. Guastella for three. Short. Guastella tips the rebound to McQueen. Bobcats with the ball to Barron. Goes to the basket and lays it in.
Well, real good possession that time.
Oh, great possession. Great offensive rebound. We have a tie ball game here.
All even at 32 with 3 minutes remaining in the first half. Stella fakes a three, gets it in the lane to McQueen. Fakes up with the turnaround jump. Good. So at halftime, Quinnipiac fights their way back, and it's a two-point game with St. John's in front, 39-37. The game, Brown along the right sideline, guarded by Martin. Now they get it to Smith at the foul line. Puts up the jump and hits.
She's had a good afternoon for St. John's.
Well, she's their top scorer.
Very skilled.
Barron, wide open for three. Good. By five into the lane to McQueen. Gets it out. Martin fakes a three. Now puts up a two and hits.
I love her offensively. I think she's the one girl for Quinnipiac that can get on a roll. I get her the ball back. When she makes one, she usually makes the next.
John's lead. Bobcats with the basketball. Barron along the left sideline into the corner. Martin for three. Good.
Like Coach Mecca said, right on time. When she makes one, she usually follows up with another bucket.
Aye. Just over 12 minutes to play. Bobcats down by two. Lob down low to Ostergaard. Goes up and lays it in.
Yeah, they don't have anybody to play her. I mean,
Barron, but it's recovered by Smith. Smith into the lane. Jumps a pass down low. Shot by McKenna is blocked out of bounds by the Bobcat. Back to the basket. Backs in. Into the lane. Jumps past right side. Cannon puts up a three and hits.
Real
and the Bobcats
feed
take the lead. Barron. Throws top of the key to Guastella. Guastella comes right, gives it off along the right sideline for Liebach. Liebach into the lane to the basket up with the left and hits.
Great move.
Seven as we ride the seesaw. Brown, cross-court pass, Hanford, bangs with Liebach, and an offensive foul against St. John's. It into the front court. Stutter steps down the lane, kicks it underneath Hanford and lays it in.
But it really special in transition. McKenna makes all the right plays.
For Barron, she falls down, gets it down low to McQueen, fakes up with the left and hits.
That was phenomenal. Awesome jump hook.
That was pretty, wasn't it?
That was pretty.
Felicia to a wide open three. You got to make them.
And Bobcats will inbound again. And this time Abshire switches places with Martin, and Abshire will take the ball out of bounds. Abshire looks, gets it in, going up is McQueen, hits the basket, and she's fouled. Side for Brown. Into the lane, Thompson fumbles the ball, and as she picks it up, travels and hands it over to Quinnipiac. Comes out of the backcourt, guarded tightly by McKenna. Comes along the left sideline into the left corner, Guastella for three. Good! Right side, fumbled by Hanford, recovers, gets it to McKenna on the left. Back to Hanford, into the right corner for Brown, eight on the shot clock.
Maybe a travel.
Gets it off. Hanford splits a double team. Goes up and lays it in. Off the rim. No good. Rebound St. John's. Red Storm by two. Quickly into the front court. McKenna hands it off. Hanford and lays it in. Under 3 minutes to play. Lob pass into the lane. McQueen up for the shot and hits. Abshire out of the back side
again. They're going to lift everybody, try to get into the post again.
Here's the Baron on the left side to Guastella, top of the key, into the lane to McQuain. Now kicks it left corner, Ostergaard. Tries to go baseline, cut off, gets it out. Baron for three. Good! Court comes across the line against McKenneth, gives the ball off to Baron. 13 on the shot clock to Abshire on the right side. Fakes, goes toward the basket, picks up, gives to Guastella. 7 on the shot clock, back to Abshire. 4 into the lane, up with the shot. Good! 27 on the shot clock, and the Bobcats lead by 3. Inbounded to McKenneth. Guarded by Baron. McKenneth comes along the right sideline, throws it, tipped, taken by Brown, though. Brown recovers, top of the key, into the lane, puts up a floater off the rim, no good. Rebound and a foul against St. John's. Ostergaard had the rebound, got fouled from behind. Well, we're going to find out right now. Inbounded, McKenneth, top of the key, 3 seconds, 2 seconds, and they don't get a double dribble. They turn it over with 0.2 seconds left. Inbounded, Abshire, and the ball game is over. Final score, Quinnipiac 75, St. John's 72.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look in the 5 and 10, glistening once again, with candy canes and silver lanes aglow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolls that will talk and will go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again.
Great win. It's a great way to go into Christmas, and I'm just really pleased that we were able to pull this one out and look really good doing it. It had to be a great one to call.
It was absolutely fabulous. And, you know, both of us said it right at the beginning. Everybody in a Quinnipiac uniform that stepped on the floor was fabulous today.
Well, we knew coming into the season that we had a lot of pieces, and you see that the season growing and us unfolding and improving, and it's really gratifying to watch how our deficiencies last week didn't catch us this week, and we were able to get better, and it's just it's a great group of young ladies to go down and work with every day. It's very enjoyable.
Well, have fun. Enjoy the holidays, and we will see you soon.
Merry Christmas to everyone listening.
Congratulations.
All right. Congratulations, Trish. All right, Trish Fabry with us here as the Bobcats pull off a big win as they beat St. John's 75-72.